Welcome to the first video on Mass Effect Andromeda. As all of you probably have heard, there has been a lot of criticism on the dialogue animations of Mass Effect. There's no denying that this isn't working properly. However, I do believe that this can and will be fixed. However, I won't deny that this is a long way from home. My personal solution to the disgusting animations, but with interesting and necessary information, is to look away and just listen. The information is handed to you through very awkwardly animated discussions, which are just a pain to watch. I do believe, however, that the story is quite interesting and well written. There's a backstory for almost every character you get to know a little, and if you're interested, you can actually start a conversation with them and get to know even more. However, this is through, again, a bunch of awkwardly animated conversation. Even
I
was convinced.
I want to learn more about your species.
What would you like to know?
Is there a central Ngaran religion?
There are many variations. An almanac could give you an accurate number. But if you are a believer, the essential tenet is, after we die, we are reincarnated. We evolve. To make our families strong, born from what was before, blessed to be better than before.
With that out of the way, with the conclusion being that it needs a lot of work since it's such a big part of the game, even though the stories are well written in my opinion. So with the biggest critique out of the way, let's take a look at the things you might want to know, and since I don't want to bother you guys with weird animations, I'm going to summarize a bit for you. The aliens found in the Helios cluster are a few from the old species and three new ones. Some of the old ones are the Asari, a monogender species, distinctively female, represented by the Doctor and Phoebe on the crew of the Tempest. There are the Turian, a very disciplined species. Their general orientation is militia, and gained their reputation in the history books by beating the Krogans. Next are the Salarians, a warm-blooded amphibian species. The Salarians are well known for their observational capabilities and tend to fulfill the roles of scientists and inventors. And the last one are the Krogans, a large reptilian species, a very tough kind and tend to live a long time, if not killed in battle. They do tend to fight a lot, though. That was a short version of the old species. Now for the new ones. We have the main enemy, which are the Kett.
He got a halo. That's pretty badass.
Fighting the Kett, talked much to them, and I haven't found out much about them either. But you can recognize them by their lumpy heads and very strong tech. We have our new allies, which are called the Angara, a blue, warm-blooded mammal that has been fighting the Kett for as long as they can remember. Part of their history is wiped out when the Kett first struck. Their original militia got taken out, and their citizens have risen to the occasion and have formed a rebellion. We will be helping these guys to restore the balance of Andromeda. And for the last species, they are currently known to me as a remnant, a very old species that made the technology to alter atmospheres of planets. These devices are hidden in vaults. Luckrack can use my personal AI called Sam to decipher these devices and help increase their viability of the planet by changing their atmospheres. Though these vaults are very similar to the Altair missions in Assassin's Creed, they're quite fun to crack. Back to the Remnant though. They are made out of black robot tech, and it almost seems like they're just guardians left by the species that actually made the vaults. This is, however, just an assumption, since I do not have any proof, nor did I do any research on it outside of the game. I'd like to find out in the game and surprise myself as the game progresses. I hope to find out more about the Remnant though, and because they seem very interesting. With the species listed and out of the way, I wanted to talk about something I mentioned ago, the viability. One of your main goals when going around planets is increasing the viability of planets to gain foothold for the initiative.
Every great moment in our history began with a dream. Each bold leap forward was achieved by those willing to do anything to attain it. We are, all of us, leaving behind families, homes, the very birthplace of our species. Some for discovery, to see the unknown. Others for a new start. But today, whatever our reasons, we take the first steps toward a new future for humanity. Today, we begin to make our dream reality.
Future begins in Andromeda.
Mass Effective is a space program, which is pretty much the start of the game, that once again foothold in the Helios cluster, where Mass Effect Andromeda takes place. The viability increases the viability of the planet and makes it easier to live. This can be done through missions and opening vaults, and even with just helping some of the currently present populations. Now I want to waste some words on something I really enjoy so far in this game, which is the combat system. There are three categories which you can skill into. Though, don't fear, you can spec into all of them, and switch between them if you like. One of the trees is a combat system, which is like any FPS game, with grenades, explosives, and mostly just firepower. It's called combat. Then the gravity tech, which is a kind of weird magic tech influencing the force of nature like gravity and such things. And then there's tech, which comes down to shield drains and more precise combat. Less mobile than biotic, less powerful than combat, but just something in between. Anyways, these three things combined make a combat very diverse and interesting. And I've been having a lot of fun playing with it. I've set my game to the hardcore difficulty and I have to do things over quite often. Still having fun though. With that being said, enough explaining, and I'll show you some live footage of me raiding a Kett base on the first planet, Eos. Right. Welcome to Eos. We're about to raid a Kett base, and I actually did the first bit. And I got pretty far last time, but I got killed. So I have to start all over again. So, all those things I explained earlier, they're relevant, but they're not really necessary, because this is what the game is about, in my opinion. The combat system is really diverse. So I picked three biotic skills. I picked one engage, one skill that can go all ways, that's the push. It can demobilize, but it can also be quite aggressive. And I have a shield, which actually shoots back projectiles straight towards the target, which is, you could call it a reflecting shield. And what I have to do now is I have to switch off the alarms. And of course there's a jump pad. Oops. And there's the melee, which is quite strong. And the shotgun I'm using is on... I'm not really sure what kind of tech it is, but I found it, and I crafted a new one with heat-seeking missiles, which is pretty awesome. And I think I have to prioritize switching off the alarm, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'll leave my team, they'll be fine. I'm using a stubborn old Krogan, and one of the new species. Job. They've been isolated for quite some time. And, let's just Taking shots on our children is pretty fucking strong. Because what happens is you it's very hard to miss. You just kind of aim in a direction and then the only thing with this shotgun is that it really runs out of ammo. As long as the alarm keeps going, they're gonna get reinforcements, which is makes the whole point of killing them kind of useless. Ammo, there we go. Health. Let's head this way. Have to access the stronghold before.
Incoming shuttle, Pathfinder.
Oh.
This place is massive.
Bigger ain't always better, except in my case.
Fucking joke. I think we're gonna be chased though. Oh, jeez. In the face. Oh boy, I'm gonna where's he going? So apparently tech and biotic have a combo. Which is kind of cool. I'm not being very cautious with my ammo because I know there's a lot of resupplies laying around in the base. Scannable around. Need the research points. Anything new you reap when you scan, gain research points for a certain faction. Those allow you to research empty, and then I got a sniper I crafted from some futuristic tech. I think it's Revenant. It looks pretty awesome, and it has no ammo, it just has charge. Every shot takes about 20%. Here. Doesn't look like it. Everything has a weak spot. In most games. You can see the orange when you hit a weak spot. Oh jeez, what's that? that the shotgun is really strong. Oh my god. Get off me. Ouch. Ow. That's really strong. Oh, that wrecked me. I'll see you here in a second. Because I gotta go all the way back where we started.
Hands up, Kett.
He's quite strong in this. Thing to do is to kill the boss, which is absolutely annoying. You have to shoot the orb, attack that thing. And run. Things that you that make your shoot disappear when you go. Without your shields, are absolutely useless. Shooting this way. Got me. Fuck. The moment I tried to shoot his ass, he leaps away. Where you at? Alright boys and girls, thank you so much for watching this video. I've put a lot of effort into the editing today, a little bit more than usual. So I gave you a bit of my first impressions, I gave you a bit of information and backstory about the game. And well, I gave you a good amount of gameplay as well. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to leave a rating, because I really, really appreciate the attention. And if you guys really like it, then I'm gonna keep going with this. I really like the game. I already got so many hours into it, so I'm not gonna stop, and I'm hoping you guys want to tag along with me. All right I hope to see you guys in the next video, where we're gonna be doing something different. I don't know yet. I'm looking to do guides on this, but of course it's a single player game, and for most people the guides are just very linear. I'm not really looking to how to farm up the best or how to level up the best, but I'm gonna try and look into the funny things or the weird things or maybe things you didn't know about. But then again, the Easter egg videos are all over YouTube already, so we're gonna see what we're gonna end up with. Maybe if you guys have an idea for it, let me know in the comment section down below, and I hope to see you guys next time. Peace out.